Born to a military family in Bordeaux, Louis trained to become a watchmaker. His desire to join a religious community went unfulfilled because he didn't know Latin. Moving to Normandy, he met Zélie, a highly skilled lacemaker who also had been disappointed in her attempts to enter religious life. They married in 1858 and over the years were blessed with 9 children, though 2 sons and 2 daughters died in infancy. Louis managed the lacemaking business that Zélie continued at home while raising her children. She died from breast cancer in 1877. Louis then moved the family to Lisieux to be near his brother and sister-in-law, who helped with the education of his 5 surviving girls. His health began to fail after his 15-year-old daughter entered the monastery of Mount Carmel at Lisieux in 1888. Louis died in 1894, a few months after being committed to a sanitarium. Home that Louis and Zélie created nurtured the sanctity of all their children, but especially their youngest, who is known to us as Saint Thérèse of the Child Jesus. Louis and Zélie were beatified in 2008 and canonized in 2015. There's more about the saints, along with inspiration and Catholic resources, at our website, saintoftheday.org. From Franciscan Media, this has been Saint of the Day.
Thank you for your kind attention.
the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, my Father.
Today's Mass we offer for the repose of the soul of Donald Missy. Let us pause to acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call the sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Every word of God is tested. He is a shield to those who take refuge in him. Add nothing to his words, lest he reprove you, and you will be exposed as a deceiver. Two things I ask of you, deny them not to me before I die. Put falsehood and lying far from me. Give me neither poverty nor riches. Provide me only with the food I need, lest being full I deny you, saying, who is the Lord? Or being in want I steal and profane the name of my God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm, our response is, your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Remove from me the way of falsehood and favor me with your law. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Your word, O Lord, endures forever. It is firm as the heavens. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. From every evil way I withhold my feet, that I may keep your words. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Through your precepts I gain discernment. Therefore, I hate every false way. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Falsehood I hate and abhor. Your law I love. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Alleluia. Repent and believe in the gospel.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus summoned the 12 and gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. And he sent them to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. He said to them, take nothing for the journey, neither walking stick, nor sack, nor food, nor money. And let no one take a second tunic. Whatever house you enter, stay there and leave from there. And as for those who do not welcome you, When you leave that town, shake the dust from your feet in testimony against them. Then they set out and went from village to village, proclaiming the good news and curing diseases everywhere. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, I just had an eye exam this morning. So reading the Gospel was a bigger challenge than I thought it would be, Father. Seeing that I can't see most of you. But very powerful gospel today. It's said before, we think that Christians is that you go forth to proclaim the gospel always. And maybe only sometimes you have to use the words, right? Okay. It only can take nothing with you. What do you need material things or in the world? You don't need them. You can choose. Yeah, sure. You're in good shape. Some people feed you, some along the line. But live the gospel. Proclaim the gospel to yourself. Think in terms of a lot of us, and back in my vintage year when I was in college, we all had our What Would Jesus Do bracelets and Jesus Greets and everything else like that. And it was always, have you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior?
Yes.
Have you?
Yes.
I don't know. Here.
Yes.
Thank you. Rough problem. That's wonderful. Personal relationship with Christ is marvelous. It's a wonderful, beautiful thing. And it's always someone that you can go to anytime at all. The Father. But we also have to realize that we're not only Christians for ourselves. We're Christians for the world. We bring Christ out into the world with ourselves. And we don't need my shoes to do it. We're second to it. Proclaim the gospel voice. By your example. In what you say and what you do. Bring Christ out into the world. Because God knows we choose a little bit more Christ than we do right now. And he's good with your life.
Amen.
Thank you. Trusting in God's mercy and compassion, let us present our prayers and petitions. Well, you're struggling with your eyes, one of
them. Much prettier than I am.
Oh, I didn't bring glasses.
The blind leading blind.
That God may enrich his church with an abundance of new religious vocations, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit may inspire political leaders with the love of the truth, let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may bless the poor with all they need to live a full and dignified life.
Lord,
let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That families in this faith community may be grounded in love of Christ and strengthened by the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may find peace and rest in our Lord's loving care, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of Donald Missy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those parishioners who are sick and suffering, for those who have requested our prayer, may God's healing power touch in body and soul, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, we know that you hear our prayers. We ask that you grant these, our humble petitions, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have received the bread we offer. For the earth and work of human hands,
He will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For to your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Acepta, Señor, nuestro corazón contrito, nuestro espíritu humilde. Que se sea tu sacrificio, que sea agradable en tu presencia. Señor Dios. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifices of your hands, the praises of your name, for our good and the cause of the Church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy there for thee, as we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Señor mío, Dios mío, tú eres mi Dios. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Señor, Dios. The mystery of faith.
For he is bread and gives us God. We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have felt us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, John, our Bishop, the auxiliary bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also Donald, our brothers and sisters who are falling asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may marry to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. But by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
With the kingdom and the power and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you for your word. God bless you.
Thank you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word, and my soul shall be
healed. The body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Thank you.
I was taking the Eucharist to our brothers and sisters. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the matter of our life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Tonight at 7 p.m. is the second part of Conversation with Clergy. Teach us to pray. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. My brothers and sisters, this Mass is ended. Go forth and be Christ to the world.
Thanks
be to God.
Join us if you can.
Bye bye.
You put us early.